Welcome to the Good Choice Preservation Vendor Training, where we are wrapping up our discussion on debris identification, documentation, and invoicing, presented November 2014. This is course 3 of 11 courses being presented. This course will focus on removal procedure. The following is an example of general guidelines for removal procedures. Please follow specific client specs and your work order. Always check for debris around the property, including behind garages and sheds. Do not leave any debris at the property or curb that is approved to be removed in your work order. Always leave the property in broom-swept condition or as required by the client, as this material must be reported and handled separate from trash debris. This is very important. Any debris created as a result of completing a work order, such as trimming of shrubs, should be included in the removal of debris approved and not billed separately. If a code violation exists, please provide the necessary information so it can be addressed. No work completed should ever create or worsen an existing code violation. Personal property should be removed if approved on a work order or as directed by law enforcement as part of an eviction. Interior debris should be removed if it constitutes a health or safety hazard as part of an eviction and is not personal property or could cause a code violation. Please always make sure that during photos showing debris being removed and loaded onto a vehicle, trailer, or dumpster are provided. Please make sure the photos are properly labeled. All after photos need to show debris loaded and uncovered. Debris must be properly identified, especially if there are multiple loads. Using placards to identify different loads is requested. Dump receipts can be provided as evidence of proper disposal. Receipts do not, under any circumstances, substitute for photos showing debris loaded and hauled away. Hazardous debris should be removed and hauled according to government regulations. Photos of the hazardous material being removed and hauled away needs to be provided and properly labeled in the current and correct bucket. Properly identify multiple loads in your photo. Any photos not so identified will only be considered as one load. Make sure to please take tape measurements of vehicles and dumpsters being used. Without proper verifiable measurements, vehicle capacity will also solely be determined by GCP and its client.